أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة. حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
لا إله إلا الله.
He's not praying. He's not praying. إن الحمد لله إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومحى الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاة وسلاما على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والفجر وليال عشر والشفع والوتر. وعن ابن عباس رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما العمل في أيام أفضل من هذه العشر؟ قالوا ولا الجهاد يا رسول الله. قال ولا الجهاد إلا رجل خرج يخاطر بنفسه وماله فلم يرجع بشيء. رواه البخاري أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد, oh praise to Allah, oh praise to Allah, the most merciful. I bear witness that he is the creator of this universe and he is the one who should be worshipped. I bear witness that Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام is his messenger. True mercy sent to us. If we follow his path, inshallah, we'll be in Jannah. أما بعد, Allah bestowed us with many bounties. Wallahi, every time, there are times that we have to opening gates for us to get extra hasanat. Extra hasanat everywhere. There are places better than places, there is times better than times, and there are nights better than nights. Let's start with places better than places. The masjid is better than your home in praying and getting more hasanat. Mecca is better than this mosque. Masjid al-Nabawi and Masjid al-Aqsa are better. How? Praying in Masjid al-Aqsa is 500 times. Ya hasanat. 500 times the hasanat will increase. Masjid al-Nabawi, 1,000 times. And Masjid al-Haram, 100,000 times. When you go and pray there, one rak'ah, it's equal to 100,000 rak'ah. Hasanat is more. Now let's go days better than days and nights better than nights. Let's start with the month. What's the best month of the year? Ramadan. It's that simple. Ramadan. Right? The best month of the year. Fasting, everything is there. And there is nights better than nights. Laylatul Qadr. Laylatul Qadr. And days better than days. The 10th of Dhul Hijjah, which they are coming next Friday or Saturday, not tomorrow, next one, are best days of the year. And best day of all is Yawm Arafah. But there is another thing we have to think about. Laylatul Qadr, everyone is trying to get it, right? We don't know when it is. Laylatul Qadr, 27th, 23rd, 25th. We don't know. But Yawm Arafah, we know. Okay, best. Now, what should we do? The hadith said the best deeds that you can accumulate are the coming 10 days. The best. Starting, like I said, Friday or Saturday next week. Now, what should we do? First, you have to know that it has all the ibadat, every worship you can do in these 10 days. You can pray, you can fast, you can give in the sake of Allah, you can pray extra sunan, you can read the Quran. All of that you can do in these 10 days. Right? Two, it has Yawm Arafah, the day of Arafah. All millions of people are there making dua in the sake of Allah. Imagine that all these millions are making dua and you make dua with them. You do the same thing with them. All of them are combined. Your dua is accepted that. Imagine millions and millions are giving the dua. Remember that these 10 days, you have to have extra dua. Like I always said before, in Ramadan, you have special dua. In these 10 days, have extra dua there. Because it's very important. This is a bounty that we need to capture. And the loser who leaves this bounty go away. Subhanallah. Definitely, definitely Eid. Slaughtering for the sake of Allah, if you can afford it, try to slaughter. If you can afford it, I believe in, if you go to all the charitable organizations that give outside, you can donate easily. A sheep or a cow or a part of a cow. It's very simple. And here we have it too. But everywhere in the world, they need it. Especially our brothers in Palestine and Gaza. Very important to know that. Definitely. Now, how can we prepare ourselves for that 10 days? One, definitely. If your cup is full, nothing will be filled in. I'll always say that. If your cup is full, how can it be full? How can our heart be full? Full of what? The heart is full of body. When you go wash, like I always say, on Friday especially, especially if you're youth, take a shower. Especially Fridays. It's a sunnah of the Prophet. Take a shower in the morning. Take a shower. Clean yourself from the outside. Make ghusl. It's called ghusl Jum'ah. You pray, you make ghusl with niyyah to attend Jum'ah. This is sunnah of the Prophet. And now, after I've done the ghusl from outside, is that it? No. There is ghusl from inside. How? Forgive everyone. Forgive everyone. Oh, my brother. He took 10 meters from me back home. Forgive him, Wallahi. It's not worth it. It's not worth it. Wallahi, both of us, both you and your brother will go away. Forgive. Wallahi, forgive. Oh, this sheikh has a loud voice. He scared me. Forgive me. Please forgive me. I beg you to forgive me. Or this or that or try to forgive. Wallahi, it's a muscle. It's not that simple. It's a muscle. Imagine that the Sahaba is sitting and the Prophet said, this man comes from Jannah. He's all what he does to go to Jannah, forgiving. He sleeps without any hatred to anyone. And if you look at yourselves now, you say, oh, who do I hate today? Who did I hate last week? My father didn't say good morning to me. My mother didn't prepare breakfast for me. Forgive. Very important. The first thing to prepare yourself for these 10 days, forgive everyone. Try your best to forgive everyone. By the way, this doesn't mean to forgive the oppressors. I didn't say that. Our people who are killed there, should we forgive them? No. The answer is no. Forgive everyone who has any rights on you. Any brother around you. That's very important. Forgive the Satan? No, don't forgive Satan. Prepare yourself and be ready for him. Always prepare yourself. Remember to have extra tasbih. Instead of hearing 680 news in the news or channel 1010 or whatever you're going to hear, have maybe 2-3 minutes before it. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar. Say it. 33 times, 33 times, 33 times, each one of them, your sins will be gone. Simple. Takes how long? 1 minute, 2 minutes. That's it. Read قُلُوا اللَّهُ أَحَدْ when you leave home. 3 times? So as if you read the whole Quran, because each قُلُوا اللَّهُ أَحَدْ is 1/3 of the Quran, as the hadith said, you read the whole Quran. Simple acts, but the problem of us that it's simple, but we need to put it in our way of life. Try to fast, even though I didn't see it's a sunnah. Try to fast, if you can. Now, you have to fast, try your best to fast on the day of Arafah. Why? And this is very important for us. Like I told you in the beginning, Yawm Laylat al-Qadr, we don't know anything about. When it is, we don't know. It's the last 10 days. You have to try your best in 10 days. You try to aim. Some people aim on the 27th. But Yawm Arafah, we know it. Starting next week, we will know exactly the date. Is it Sunday or Saturday? Simple. Can we fast only, by the way, this day? Yes. Alone? Yes. Now, What's the reward? The only deed that forgives, as far as I know, deed that forgives the sins of last year and forgives the sins that you didn't do this year. 2 years of sins are gone. The only ibadah I heard that it forgives the sins that you're going to do. I haven't seen that in any ibadah. All ibadah, prayer now, forgives whatever you did before. Right? But this ibadah only forgives what's coming. Imagine that every year we fast that day. Every year. You're going to meet Allah with what? Clean slate. Nothing there. You're ready already. You're preparing yourself. يكفر سنة ماضية وسنة بخير. Last year and this year. Every year. Do we need it? I predicted it last year. Do you need it this year? Every year. The sins we do, wallahi, very, very sometimes, like I give the example all the time, we do sins that even we don't know that we did it. I give the example every time. Wallahi, I remember it until today. I was driving alone in the road and turning left. And a car came behind me. I didn't see the car. Came behind me flying and start honking. I didn't do anything. I don't know. I did a sin, definitely. I cut him. I don't know. What did I do? Until now. And I remember it. I don't know. What did I do? Imagine how many times you do that. How many times that this person didn't honk in you or didn't even look at you or looked at you badly. How many times? A lot, subhanAllah, that we really need all the hasanat that we can get. Give in the sake of Allah. Try to give. Everyone I know, we did a lot in Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, jazakum Allah khair. Everyone is donating in Ramadan. But try to give more, a little bit. That's why I tell everyone all the time, try to split the money. Half of it in Ramadan, or 3/4 of it in Ramadan, and the rest across the year. Across the year, you're gonna pay $1,000, $500 in Ramadan. And the rest $500 across the year. Every week you put something. Every week. Why? The connection. Allah, the Prophet said, the best deeds that you can do is the continuous deeds. Even if it's not that much. You pray every night 2 rak'ah. Every night of your life. This is good deed. Whatever continuous deed, it's connection between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then extra sunan in these 10 days. The sunans are multiplied. Definitely you have to remember to attend Salatul Eid. Salatul Eid is very important. Very important to attend. Eid. Try your best to bring everyone. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam even asked the ladies who don't have prayer, even the ladies who don't have prayer, to attend Eid. Then try your best to attend. Inshallah, next week we'll tell you what's our plans here in this mosque, inshallah. But for now, may Allah forgive us all and make us all from the here to here and adhere. Jazakum Allah khair. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfiru lakum fastaghfiru ya fawza al-mustaghfirin. Astaghfiru azmali. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين ونستغفر ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. أما بعد, everyone now, someone because of Eid, it's a joke, it's not here, but I have to say it. Someone told me that I hope that you can go to Hajj. I told him Hajj now is kind of a mortgage now. Subhanallah, it's a mortgage. It's almost $15,000-$16,000 per person. This is the cheapest. You're far away, you're maybe sitting outside the borders of Mecca somewhere to go to do that, which is crazy now. Really, really, you have to wonder how can you do it. But maybe, inshallah, alhamdulillah, I did it when I was young, but I'm talking about my kids and whoever didn't do it. But now, with that being said, can I do it here in Oakville? The answer is yes. How? Like I said before, come, pray Fajr, sit in your place until Duha, it's equal to Hajj and Umrah. It's that simple. I'm not saying that you go Hajj here around Oakville, downtown Oakville, and go, no, I didn't say that. You have, if you can afford it, go do Hajj. If you can afford it, go do Hajj. If you can afford $15,000, go and do Hajj. Definitely. But to get the reward. If you don't have to, you don't have to get money from line of credit to do it. Don't. If you cannot afford it out of your money, then stay. Okay? Now, because of that, this is the joke I remember. And really, I was thinking, but anyway, alhamdulillah. May Allah help us and make us peep all next year, inshallah, in Hajj, inshallah. This is very important, inshallah. Now, have the niyyah, the intention to try to go there, inshallah. Now, I have two things to talk about by the end of the khutbah. You know that our brothers and sisters in Palestine are attacked everywhere. And really, they need your, not only your dua, try your best to give in the sake of Allah. And this is, again, the 10 days of giving. Try to find a charitable organization, try to give meat there. It's very expensive there to get some food there. But there are organizations that they can do that. One of them is here, Hands of Charity. Try to give them. Look at the website and send them. They have their ways. It's not our problem. They have their ways to give it there. Their Ikna Relief, Isna Relief, all of them are helping. And by the way, when I say Palestine, I didn't exclude India. Some people from India came to we're attacked left and right. Yes. We're attacked left and right. In India, in Pakistan, Syria, in Egypt, in Iraq, everywhere. Everywhere. But why always these days we're concentrating on Palestine? Every country of this world, their government is taking care of their torture. But this place, all the world is going to them. The bad part, even Canada here, I heard that they're sending forces, which is, if Justin Trudeau says me, please pull your forces out. It's not right. We are Canada here. We believe that we came because it's a country of peace. We shouldn't be forced in any of these things. But anyway, that's one problem we're facing. The second problem is tomorrow, the flag starts. And our kids now, we need to talk to them, to prepare them of what's happening in schools. What's happening in genders and fluidity and these kind of things. We have to talk to them. I know it's scary and everyone is scared to talk about it. But you have to find a way. They are taking our kids, our families from us. What can we do to help and support? Very important. Try your best to learn. There should be NCCM, there should be here. But this khutbah, they are late, but maybe next khutbah, they are lawyers. They can support and they can help. And they tell us, how can we deal with these problems? Think about it. Think about it. How can we deal? I don't want our kids to go away. When I came here in 97, I was scared that my son or my daughter would have a boyfriend or a girlfriend. I was scared. Honestly, I was scared. And I always try to go around them, make sure that they don't do that, and talk to them. Now, the problem is very, very much complicated than that. More complicated than a boyfriend or a girlfriend. It's worse, I think. I'm sure. And I'm telling even my son or my daughter that this, when I came in, I was scared of that. Now you have to be scared for more. To prepare yourself for the attack. And it's attack on humanity itself. It's not attack on religion now. It's on humanity itself. I'm not sure who behind it, but if you go conspiracy theory, you can think about it this way. Because it happened in all the world in one time. Every part of the world, one time. Even back home. What's funny? Back home. You cannot demonstrate, three people back home, you cannot come in one road and say anything, anything, except them. They did it. They raised the flag and went through the roads. And everyone is accepted. What? I cannot raise a flag to say Palestine. I cannot. Back home. I cannot. Or Syria, or Iraq, or even any part, anything. I cannot. But they did it. How? I don't know how. But they did it. And I believe they'll do it this year too. I don't know who's supporting them. But anyway, what I'm saying is, think about it. Try your best. Try your best to stand. Try your best at least to take care of your family, your immediate family. Talk to your son, talk to your daughter, go to the mosque, pray with them. Make sure that you're united. It's coming tomorrow. It's not a joke. And they are very well organized, more than us, 100% more than us. Let's think, how can we manage this problem? Don't let it go. Don't say, oh, not my problem. Or as for example, some of us, alhamdulillah, like me, as for example, I can say, the youngest son of mine is almost 20 now. Don't care. No, I have a grandson here who I care about. And a granddaughter I care about. And grandson and so on, I care about. What's your input? What's your input? Think about it. Try your best to take care of them. Take care of them. Try to join. Try to be creative. Don't wait for others to think for you. Try to find the solution. Try to come up with a solution. Maybe your solution is better than mine. Come, attend, join, inshallah, and try to create programs to do that. Wisely, nicely, under the law. Because they are good in attacking us. They are very good. May Allah help us all, inshallah. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt. Allahumma ahdina fi man hadayt. Wa'afina fi man afayt. Allahumma ajma'na wa la tufarriqna. Allahumma ajma'na wa la tufarriqna. Allahumma aghnina bihalalika an haramik wa biqudratika amman siwak. Allahumma taqabbal minna Ramadan. Allahumma taqabbal minna Ramadan. Allahumma taqabbal minna Ramadan. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل ليلة القدر، اللهم اجعلنا من أهل يوم عرفات، اللهم اكتب لنا الحج يا رب العالمين. وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين، وقوموا لصلاتكم ورحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة. اسمعني الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله،
المفروض ثبت لا تثبت.
حي على الصلاة، حج على الفلاح، قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة.
صلي جنبي،
صلي جنبي. الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استووا، ترسوا صمون، استووا. الله أكبر. اللهم بعد بيني وبين المتقين من الذين أخذوا من الذين أخذوا إلى مشترش. بسم الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى، سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله، إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى، ونيسرك لليسرى، فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى، سيذكر من يخشى، ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى، ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا، قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى، بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى، إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى، صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. والعصر، إن الإنسان لفي خسر، إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر عزيز مسيح حقا مطبول. استغفر عزيز مسيح حقا مطبول. استغفر عزيز مسيح. اللهم عيني على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. الله عليكم. تخذ سمع الله. شفعان ذلك. يا رب.